Hey, shout out to all my Idaho friends. It's supposed to be like 80 degrees this week. It's crazy. But that's not what this video is about. I wanted to quickly talk about, as you guys can tell from the title, an unfortunate truth when it comes to bodybuilding. And keep in mind again, I'm going to try and stabilize this a little bit better because I'm shaking. Keep in mind again that bodybuilding is not necessarily just the mass monsters that you see at the Olympia and everything. Like, bodybuilding covers every class that there is in fitness competitions, everything. So you have men's physique, you have classic physique, you have bodybuilding, you have bikini, women's figure, women's physique. I mean, there's tons of different classes. They're all considered bodybuilding. So when I'm saying bodybuilding, I'm talking about all of those. So the main thing that I want to talk about is, for anybody who is on this diet with me or dieting down for summer or anything like that, you will notice a couple of different things that happen. So the first is, if you're a brand new beginner and you're just now like getting into lifting, anything like that, you're probably going to notice that while you're losing weight, you're going to be building up some muscle. Not a lot, because people think it's really easy to build muscle. It's not, but it is easier for beginners. If you're getting the right nutrition, you're getting the right, protein, the right macros, basically the right amount of protein and everything, then you're going to see some growth in your muscle while also losing fat. Now, for people like me who have been lifting for over 5 years, it is nearly impossible. I'm saying nearly because it's not 100%, but nearly impossible to gain muscle while cutting and losing fat. Because your body needs X amount of calories in order to maintain, in order to grow, in order to lose weight. When you're cutting your calories, you're getting less than your body needs in order to maintain. So it is in turn cutting weight. At the same time, those nutrients are not going to fill up your muscles as much and rebuild your muscles as much as if you were in a caloric surplus, where you're getting more calories than your body needs. So that's one of the things that I wanted to mention, is you know, that's one thing that's very hard about dieting for somebody who is into muscles and everything, is that you're going to realize that you're not really gaining size. Now, one great thing that does happen, kind of as an alternative to it, is that you do look like you're getting bigger sometimes, because you're cutting all the fat around your muscles, so it's tightening everything up. You'll start noticing different veins that you're seeing, and just more like your skin will feel tighter on your muscles, and your muscles might start bulging out a little bit more if you already have existing muscle and things like that. So that is one of the nice things. Like right now during my cut, I actually feel a little bit bigger than normal because I have been losing so much fat. So my shoulders pop out a little bit more, my arms pop out a little bit more, all of that. So it actually feels good, but the only way to truly measure is if you use like a measuring tape. They have specific ones for bodybuilders and stuff that wrap around the muscle, but even then it's still kind of hard because you're getting the fat in there when you're measuring. So it's just one of those things I wanted to talk to you guys about, to make sure that you're not getting discouraged if you're not putting on any size while you're dieting, because it's not something that often happens. The other thing I would say is that when you are dieting, you're going to start noticing that your clothes aren't fitting. And again, this video is more so tailored towards bodybuilders or people who enjoy muscle, not just people who are trying to lose some pounds before summer. Let's say you don't really lift that much and you just want to lose some weight. This video is not really tailored to you as much, but because it would be a good thing for you guys to lose some weight and have clothes not fit, right? But for a bodybuilder, it sucks, because you're like, man, I was filling out this, you know, like I have some business shirts that I wear to work and I fill them out during my off season, and then now they're kind of fitting baggy. Same with my work pants. And that, it's like, crap, well, are my legs really getting that much smaller? Are my arms getting small? And yes, unfortunately they are. And it kind of makes you feel smaller. Like I feel really, really skinny when I'm cutting, because I lose, you know, typically around 20 pounds or so. But it's one of those things, it's, you know, the give and take of the sport and everything. But I just wanted to kind of give you guys a little bit of, I guess, motivation, so that when you do run into that, you're not feeling down, you're not feeling, crap, I'm small. You guys have a goal for a reason. If you're setting your goal to lose weight and to gain muscle, it's going to be very, very hard. Now, you can maintain, if you're maintaining your calories, you can probably put on a little bit of muscle while staying lower fat. But just know that whenever you put on muscle, you typically almost always are going to gain some fat with it. So there's my little 5-minute rant on that. I guess not really a rant. I just wanted to kind of give you guys that information. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. Let me know if you guys like these shorter videos or if you like the longer ones, like my last one was 16 minutes. But let me know in the comments below. We'll catch you guys in the next video. See ya.